In this video, I'm going to have a look at how to build Choropleth maps on top of some open data from the UK's Office for National Statistics using Power BI and Icon Map Pro. So before we get into building the report, let's have a look at our data. So I've got two different tables of data in my semantic model. I've got a table of crime data, which contains a row for each crime that has committed in March 2023 across the whole of England. And then I've got a geography hierarchy table, which rolls up from lower super output area up to local authority district and then up to region. And these two tables are joined together using that lower super output area code. So let's kick off by adding our Icon Map Pro visual onto our report canvas. I'm going to resize the visual so that it fills up most of my report. And then I'm going to drag in my my local authority district code into the ID field. And then I'm also going to drag it into this GeoJSON KML tile feature reference box so that Icon Map Pro knows that we want to create a Choropleth map and we want to match our local authority districts to the local authority districts in our shapefile. So where do we get the shapefile from? Well, let's head over to Office for National Statistics Open Geography portal. And from here, we can download boundary data. So from the boundaries drop-down menu, I'm going to go to administrative boundaries. I'm going to go down to local authority districts, and 2022 boundaries. In here, we get a choice of number of different files with different levels of detail, but they're all showing the same boundaries. I'm going to choose to see the preview of this one. And then download the ESRI shapefile. So with that downloaded, let's head back into Power BI. And now if I go to the formatting options for Icon Map Pro, down to data layers, I'm going to turn off circles because in fact we're going to show a shapefile. So let's turn that on, expand out the configuration options. And in this case, I'm going to use an uploaded file. So if I hit the toggle here for display file upload button, this allows me to hit this blue button over here and select the file that we've just downloaded. This will take a moment just to process that file as it's loaded in to Power BI. And here we are. Here is our shapefile with all of the areas in blue that have been recognized and matched against our local authority district code in our data. And the ones in gray are those areas that we didn't have any data for, but are still in the shapefile. And what I can do is I can choose to hide those unmatched shapes so that they don't impact our report. The other thing that I can do is I can tell Icon Map Pro that I want to match on a specific field in my shapefile. So I'm going to type in LAD22 code so that we're just checking against that one field in our shapefile rather than checking all of the different properties that might be in there. This just improves performance when we're rendering a lot of different shapes and we have a lot of different rows of data. The other thing I'm going to do in here is apply some conditional formatting. So if I expand out the formatting option for our shapefile and choose conditional formatting in here, let's switch to gradient, and I'm going to base it on the number of crimes. And let's change the outline color as well. So now you can see we've got a straightforward Choropleth map showing which local authorities in England have had the highest amount of crime in March last year. But let's say I want to create a hierarchy and be able to drill down into each of these local authorities and see them in more detail. Well, it's a simple matter of saying that I want two different drill down levels. I've also downloaded the same ESRI shapefile for lower super output areas. So let's toggle that button again, and this time add the lower super output areas into our report. Now this is a big file, so it will take just a moment to process. So now that's processed, all I need to do is go back into my field settings and say that I want to be able to drill down into lower super output area. We're going to add on that field so that it can be also matched against our shape files. And then, because I've told it I'm matching on specific fields, I also need to be able to tell it which field in my shapefile I'm going to check against. And now, hopefully, I should be able to click on any one of these local authorities and drill down into that next level of detail. The other thing I can do is add in a slicer onto our report and zoom into particular regions. So for example, if I want to filter to London, what we get is now the local authorities that make up London, and then I can even use the drill down options and view all of the low super output areas that relate to London all at one time.